Hello viewer, welcome to Artistry. I am your teacher, Lidya Kimue, from SOS Technical Training Institute in Buruburu Phase 2. We have been making a short, and so far, we have managed to make the side pocket or the hip pocket. We have also managed to make the fly front opening, which is a zipped opening. We have also been able to make the back bound pocket or the double jetted pocket. We are now going to attach the front to the back, and we are going to start off by making the back crutch seam. This is what we call the crutch. This is the crutch. We are going to start by making the back crutch seam, but we shall not make the whole of it. We shall just make it up to a certain point because we need to first attach the waistband before we can complete that crutch opening. Therefore, we shall just stitch a part of the back crutch opening, then join the back side seams to the front side seams. Watch as we go. Start stitching at halfway of the crutch seam and stitch on your seam line. Remember to curve as you work. We need to reinforce that stitching line, but we will do so as we make the rest of the back. Open up your back. And now take your front piece and place it over your back, right sides together. Match your side seams. And stitch. Ensure that your seams balance, making sure you catch all pieces and stitch at your seam line and not anywhere away from your seam line. Do not take in more seam allowance than you had left or less seam allowance. Cut off your thread. This is how your pocket should look after you have made your seam. Now attach the other side seam to the front. Cut off your thread. Now we have worked the side seams. The back piece is always larger than the front piece, so do not worry when you see one looking larger than the other. Now we shall work our inside leg seam. The inside leg seam is this one. And remember, we are joining the back to the front also. When we come to the crotch line or the crotch seam, that is for the back and for the front, we shall form something we call an intersecting seam. When we have intersecting seams, we make sure that the lines actually meet, and that is the way they should look. Therefore, make sure you pin them together and stitch. Stitch from the one side at the crotch line to the hemline, and do the same for the other. This will allow us to have our seam allowance free so that we can neaten it before we hold it down. So I'm making this inside leg seam. Turn the other side and do the same, ensuring that your seams are intersecting. And once you have made your seams, now we are ready to overlock. We shall go to the overlock and overlock our seams together. When we overlock our seams together, we form a closed seam, plain closed seam. We have plain, two kinds of plain seams. When the seam allowances are overlocked separately, we call that a plain open seam, but we shall use the plain closed seam. Let us go and overlock. Start overlocking by overlocking the back crotch seam. Open up your seam allowances and overlock each seam allowance alone. Remember to overlock with the right side up. Always, as you overlock, ensure there's nothing else underneath that it may not be cut off. Cut off all your hanging threads. Now, you can overlock the inside leg. Ensure that your front is on top and the back is underneath, and overlock the two seam allowances together to form the closed playing scene. Overlock the side seams with your front on top and your back under. Overlock the seam allowances together. And also for the other side. Ensure nothing else is underneath and your piece lies flat on the overlock. We shall also overlock the hem. And as we overlock the hem, the right side should be on top. Your seam allowances should lie from the front to the back, like this piece, from the front to the back. And the right side of the short is what is on top, and the wrong side is underneath. Ensure that you level your pieces. Do the same for the other side. From the front to the back with the right side up. And the seam allowances from the front to the back. That's the way the seam allowance should lie on the trouser. It needs to be caught in the overlock. Always ensure that any seam that runs into another seam should be neatened before it is caught in that seam. We have now finished our overlocking. That is the way our overlocked piece looks like. Notice that our seam allowance lies from the front to the back, and it has been caught in the bottom overlock. So is that of the inside leg. It lies from the front to the back, and it has also been caught in the seam allowance or in the overlock. Now we shall go and iron. Now we iron. Always be conscious of the temperature of your iron so as not to burn. In case you're not sure, you could always iron your cloth and touch with your hand to feel the temperature. If it is too hot, then reduce. If it is too low, then increase. Always begin ironing with at the edge, so that if it burns, you only burn an edge. Iron your seams flat. And you iron from the wrong side. You can now turn to the right side. And give it a good press too. And especially at the intersecting seams, okay, we shall now form our hem. Fold your hem allowance. Ensure that the seams meet like that and form your hem. It should be even. Just form it with the iron box so that when you go to the machine, you just stitch it down. Form the other leg's hem. And ensure that the short is equal in length. One is not longer than the other. Therefore, place the legs together evenly on top and ensure at the waist they are also together, and now form the hem for the other leg. When it is even, iron it down. And now we can go to the machine and stitch our hem down. Now stitch down your hem after ironing. Ensure that your stitching line is at the same level, because this line shall be seen and it needs to be neat. Now we do the second leg. Ensure that this hemline is the same, or the hem allowance you take down is the same. Make a straight line, because this line shall be seen. And crooked lines will always show, and they look very untidy. As you stitch, ensure your seam allowances lie flat. And we have now made our hem, cut off the hanging thread. And that's the way our hemline looks like, and also for the other side. Our shirt is almost ready. We now are left with just making the waistband or attaching the waistband, and our shirt shall be ready. We have come to the end of our lesson. I am your teacher, Lidya Kimue, from SOS Technical Training Institute. Stay tuned.
Bye.